appoint the chancellor, then you are controlling everybody. But I keep wondering, I mean, when you form a business, you take control of the board and you decide how the board decisions are done, isn't it? If you are a public institution, government has naturally has to have the determining say what you do. This shouldn't be a problem. Appointment of chancellor, the existing situation is that, especially the post-PNDC laws, I've listed them, they empower the councils to appoint the chancellor. The PNDC laws actually empower the president himself to do that. The exception is University of Ghana. University of Ghana actually has an electoral college in their law, consisting of council and academic board that elect the chancellor. We have proposed, a proposed amendment is to provide for appointment of chancellor by the president of the republic in consultation with the councils. So the councils will do the due diligence and present what recommendation to the president for appointment. The reason for this is clarity in accountability to the appointing authority, and it resolves the anomaly and contradiction of council appointing a person who then takes precedence over it. If you look at the current enactment, the council is the one that appoints the chancellor, and once the chancellor is appointed, then he takes precedence over the council going forward. Okay. It looks like, you know, a situation where you have the mandate to appoint your boss. And so when there's a problem, in terms of resolving the conflict becomes a problem. It reinforces government's role as a business owner. And from all the institutions, the countries that have the same historical antecedents that we have in Africa and elsewhere, this is what the practice has been.